Hi, my friend. I want to talk to you about the number one most important and most overlooked step that I see aspiring authors make on their journey to writing nonfiction. So this could be writing your memoir. It could be doing a self-help personal growth book, a spirituality book. It could be what I call a teaching memoir, which is where you tell your story, but you also talk directly to the reader about what their life is like and what you would suggest they do in order to overcome the obstacles that you yourself have overcome. If you're writing that kind of book, you've got to watch this video. Most overlooked tip, I'm going to save you a lot of time, energy, and money. My name is Kelly Notaris. I am the founder of KN Literary Arts. You can find us at knliterary.com. We help authors at all stages of the game get to the next place in their journey to get their book into the world. I've worked at some of the biggest publishers in the United States, including HarperCollins, Penguin, Hyperion, Sounds True, and I've actually done a lot of work with Hay House. And on that journey, I've learned a lot about what works and what doesn't work. And I tell you all of it here in this YouTube channel for free. So please click subscribe and click the little bell so that you'll always get an alert when I have a new video. All right, today's video is about the number one most overlooked tip that I want you to know, because I want you to take this step on your journey to getting your book into the world. So many of my authors do not do it. So one of the things that I love that I do via my company is that I offer 1-hour book consultations. So this is the only service that I personally still offer to my clients, because I don't have time to do a full edit. It takes a lot of time, or ghostwriting, which I used to do. Now I do these book consultations, and I spend almost every one of them, a big part of it, talking about this exact step. Okay, so many times people come to me and they say, well, I know I have a book in me. Life is asking for this book. I've learned so much. I've gone on this amazing journey, and now I want to offer that wisdom to other people. And I want to offer it in the form of a book. And they say, but what I don't really know is kind of how the material should unfold. What parts of my story should I tell? Am I really giving them the information that they need in order to be able to use this material in the way I want them to use it? And that's because the reason those questions arise is that they've actually overlooked the first step, which any company that is putting something out into the world that they want to be of use and value to their clientele, they do a stage called R&D. R&D is research and development. And that is the step that so many of my authors overlook on their journey to getting their book into the world. They do not do the R&D, the research and development on their content, on their story, on their ideas, before they start turning their attention toward putting it into a book form. Now, the thing that's so crazy about that is that, you know, if you're doing a YouTube video, you can do a YouTube video, throw it up, see what happens. You know, people will write to you, people will put comments, they'll tell you whether or not what it is that you're talking about is interesting to them and useful to them, right? You'll get a certain number of people watching the video, and it might go viral because people are searching for that idea and they're watching your video all the way through because it's really useful. You'll start to get feedback from the world, and it's very, very easy to do that. You just throw up this video and see what happens, right? What I don't understand is why my authors think I'm going to write a book. That's like a year and a half, 2, 3, 4 year process. And if you want to really get the word out about it, you're going to be talking about it for 3 to 5 years once it's published. You shouldn't do that without actually getting some reverb from the world about whether or not your ideas are working in that order, whether or not the storyline is working. Now, definitely, there's a point in the journey where you can go to an editor, and if you already have an outline, for example, or you already have a partial manuscript, an editor can give you an assessment and tell you whether it's working in terms of the book, right? So that's a great way to work if you want to get some feedback on your book before the book is in the world. But even before that, I want you to test drive your ideas, your step-by-step methodology, your storyline on actual people and see whether it's working the way you're conceiving it. Because until you do that, you have no idea whether you're going to put all this time, energy, effort, and money into getting this book in the world and find out on the other side that it's actually not working for people. And if it's not working, that equals they are not going to pass it along to friends and colleagues and family. That's the number one way that books get out into the world and that your message or your story actually has the impact that you want it to have, actually serves people, helps people. So many of the people that come to us here at KN Literary Arts, they want to help people. And I know you might be that same type of person. You really want to help people with your book. Your book will do no good if nobody reads it. They have to think this book is fantastic to give it the time and energy to read all the way through, right? There's so many things we could be doing with our time in this day and age. We could be, you know, watching YouTube videos. We could be doing Facebook. We could be hopefully talking to our families and enjoying our lives, going for a walk, gardening, whatever it might be. To have someone take the time to read your book, it has to be excellent and it has to work for them. The only way you will know whether your book content is working is if you have done that R&D step. You have done something like, for example, this is one of the things I tell people to do, which I love. Now, you don't have to do this, but you'll understand more about what I mean by R&D when I explain it. A lot of times people will come to me with a book proposal partially written or at least a book outline. And I will say, what I want you to do is take each chapter in this outline and I want you to create a teaching module with that chapter content. Just start looking at it as curriculum for one, you know, online course module, one night of teaching, okay? And then I want you to invite the people that are already in your network. This could be the people on Facebook. This could be people that you've got maybe already on a newsletter list, your friends and family. Invite them at a very, very low price. Charge them a little something or else they won't show up, because people only, for whatever reason, seem to really commit to things that they've paid for. So you want to make them pay a little bit and say you were doing a 6-week course with each one of my chapters is one of those nights of content. And then I want you to teach it. Now that could be, if you're writing a teaching memoir, for example, you start by telling that section of your story, and then you have the exercises or the integration material, the teaching points that come out of that piece of your story that you can then actually offer in a teaching way to the people that are on your course. If you're writing more of a straightforward nonfiction book, self-help, personal growth, prescriptive nonfiction, then it's very, very easy. You can just start teaching the content that you already had mapped out for that chapter. You will learn so much in that 6 weeks, you are not even gonna believe it. People will give you real-time feedback about whether or not the ideas you're presenting are fully cooked or whether you need to think about them some more, whether the exercises are actually impactful or not. And as part of this, what I call, this is a beta online course you're gonna be teaching. That beta online course, you'll ask them to join it, and you'll ask them when they join to agree to give you feedback the night after you give, you know, you basically give the teaching, and then you send them an email asking them what worked for you, what didn't work for you, what could I do better? And they have agreed in advance they're going to give you that feedback. You also can use the stories that they share as part of the discussion, the sharing portions, or maybe you have a Facebook group where you ask people to do homework, and you get to use those stories with changing all identifying characteristics so no one would ever know whose story it was, but you can use those success stories, the people who've actually used your content and gotten the success or the outcome that they wanted from it, you can then talk about them in your book, and it gives you a more sense of an expertise, right? Because you've actually taught it to people. That R&D phase. Now, again, some of you might not want to teach an online course. That's fine. There are other ways to R&D. You can write blogs and see what the feedback is. You can do a YouTube channel. You could do a podcast. You could write on your, you know, you could write Facebook posts. But I want you to really take the time to test drive the content that you are about to commit to the page, because once it's on the page, it is so difficult to change. So I want to talk a little bit about my book, The Book You Were Born to Write, because this is a book that I did not have to think twice about writing. I knew exactly what I needed to write. I knew exactly what should go in every chapter because I had been teaching this content. I've been working with authors for, you know, I think 18 years at the time I started writing this book. And I've been working directly with the people who are my audience for this book, which is, you know, folks like you probably, who want to write a book that will change the world. I've been working with those folks for 5 years at that point, and I talked to them every single day, and I'd walked through the process of what it takes to get from idea to a book in your hand so many times, I didn't have to think twice about it. I want you to have that same sense of certainty about what your content is when you sit down to write it. It will make the writing process so much easier. You're not gonna be laboring over it because you already know, because you've already tested it, because you've already brought it to the masses. Now, many of you are gonna be like, I don't wanna do that. I just wanna write a book. That's totally fine. I always say, sometimes people are writing a book for their heart or their art. And that is just as legitimate as changing people's lives. But to change people's lives, if that's on you're writing it for your heart, and you need it to change people's lives in order to feel fully satisfied, like you got the return on the investment of putting this book in the world, you need to check it out with actual people and see whether or not it changes their lives. Whether that's just telling your story and putting it out there and seeing what people think about it, or whether it's teaching the content in an online course, like I said, one-on-one coaching context, teaching it as a podcast, you know, a series podcast, or maybe you do it as a series on YouTube. Until you do that, you will not know for sure whether or not all that time, energy, effort, and expense you're going to put into getting the book in the world will actually do the thing you need it to do. So I hope that this has been helpful. I know sometimes it sets people back a bit and they're like, oh, I don't want to do that. And I always say, here's the deal. It takes 10 years to be an overnight success. Every one of us has to put in the time and energy. You know, if you want to be a thought leader, you actually have to commit to the content you're doing at a level that is well above and beyond the commitment that other people who are not thought leaders have to whatever their own ideas are. This is a path of commitment, of practice, of keeping going even when it's hard, okay? If that's what you want to do, if you want to impact people's lives, then take a moment, grieve the fact that it might not be just stepping forward and writing your book, but that you actually are going to have to do the vulnerable and difficult work of finding out whether your storyline, whether the path you walked actually works for other people by checking it out in real time. Once you do that, you will have a different level of confidence. You'll carry a different level of weight in terms of what you know and your expertise. People read books because they believe that the person who's the author is more of an expert than they are. So you have to make sure that you are indeed more of an expert than they are. Yes, you're an expert in your own story, but are you an expert in which pieces of your story are most impactful and actually most transformational for other people? Until you've taught your story, you will not know. And I want that for you. All right. So as always, KN Literary Arts, we are here to help you every step of the journey. We can do book coaching. We can do marketing coaching. If you want to get into the question mark of like, how do I get my work into the world to do this step first, we can walk you through all of that. Visit us at knliterary.com. And in the meantime, know that if life is asking for this book from you, it needs this commitment. I know you can do it. It's what all of your favorite authors have done. None of them just sprang up with a book having not brought it to the world in another way, truly. And I promise you, it is worth the time and energy and effort, because getting the emails that I get from my book, getting the emails from this YouTube channel, it really just touches my heart in such a deep way that I have been of service. And I want that experience for you as well. All right. I hope that this is helpful to you. Let us know in the comments below. And in the meantime, as always, happy writing.